Wearing high heels may be stylish, but beneath that elegance and style, an unhealthy amount of pressure is being exerted on your joints. Bones are cramped together in a very tight space, leading to altered posture. This altered posture increases the pressure on your knee joints by up to 26%, leading to a condition known as osteoarthritis or joint degeneration. When heels are consistently worn for extended periods, typically over several weeks, the calf muscles can shrink by up to 13%, causing them to lose their strength. Because these muscles are forced to contract and adjust to the angle of your high heels, they shorten and tighten over time. Once you switch to flat shoes, the calf muscles are forced to stretch again, which can be extremely painful. Prolonged use of high heels can lead to Morton's neuroma, a condition that causes the thickening of tissue around the nerves in your toes, often resulting in pain and numbness between the third and fourth toes. Wearing high heels frequently can also shorten and tighten the Achilles tendon, leading to heel pain. High heels raise the heel bone off the ground, reducing the stretching of the calf muscles and the contraction of the Achilles tendon. Over time, this can cause the Achilles tendon to become shorter and less flexible, resulting in issues like inflammation, tears, ruptures of the tendon, and abnormal walking patterns. Extended use of high heels can lead to discomfort in your feet, especially if you already have bunions. Bunions are bony bumps that develop at the joint of your big toe, causing it to bend towards your other toes. High heels can make this problem worse by putting extra pressure on the joint, pushing your toes into an unnatural position. The rigid backs or straps of high heels can irritate the heel, causing a bony enlargement known as Haglund's deformity. The enlargement of the bone at the rear of the heel can irritate the retrocalcaneal bursa, a fluid-filled sac situated between the Achilles tendon and the calcaneus bone. This irritation can lead to bursitis, causing the bursa to become inflamed and swollen. High heels can affect posture by pushing the center of mass forward, causing misalignment of the hips and spine. They also force the body's weight to be redistributed, potentially causing joint pain in the ball of the foot, a condition known as metatarsalgia. This condition is characterized by pain beneath the front part of the foot. The weight redistribution caused by high heels puts excessive pressure on the metatarsals, leading to their displacement and the collapse of the forefoot structure. As the heel height goes up, pressure on the forefoot can increase significantly. For example, 3-inch heels can increase pressure on the forefoot by 76%. High heels that feature narrow toe boxes can exert substantial pressure on the balls of your feet, causing your toes to be cramped for the duration of wear. This leads to an imbalance in the muscles, tendons, and ligaments of your toes, ultimately leading to a condition known as hammer toe, which is characterized by an abnormal bending or deformity of one or more of the toes. Over time, the muscles in the second, third, and fourth toes lose their ability to straighten. If left untreated, hammer toe can progress and eventually necessitate corrective surgery. High heels force the foot into a pointed position, increasing the risk of ankle sprains and twists. With higher heels, more body weight is shifted forward, necessitating a backward lean and greater lower leg muscle effort for balance. The greater the heel height, the higher the chances of losing balance and sustaining foot or ankle injuries, including ankle sprains, fractures, and potentially serious ones that may require surgery. Some experts advise against wearing high heels altogether due to their potential health risks. Others suggest moderation, recommending heels no higher than 2 inches to prioritize comfort. If you're committed to wearing high heels, there are several strategies to reduce the strain on your feet. First, consider switching to flat shoes when you're in no need to wear heels, such as in the office, and vary the height of your heels to provide occasional relief for your calf and foot muscles. You should also incorporate daily Pilates exercises into your routine to stretch and relax these muscles. Whether through self-practice or attending Pilates classes that include stretching routines, gentle calf and foot massages, and ankle range of motion exercises. These regular exercises, either in class or at home, can help maintain balanced posture and strengthen your hips, spine, and knee joints that may be affected by high heel use. Try practicing proper heel-to-toe walking and improving your posture. Make sure your high heels have proper padding and cushioning, and aim for wider heels to avoid cramming your toes into a tight space. Always remember to take breaks from heels and reserve them for special occasions only. And finally, occasionally walking barefoot can be beneficial for the well-being of your feet.